Hi, I'm Natalie. Welcome to my channel Traveler Paints. I am very excited and quite nervous about today's video because I'm doing a collaboration with the wonderful Julie Vetcher, who does the most stunning and beautiful abstract and semi-abstract landscapes with fluid paints. And I really admire her work. She is very creative, always trying out new things, and she often carefully plans what she wants to do and comes up with beautiful results. And the collaboration with her was quite a challenge because we agreed to use the same photo reference, a wonderful sunset shot taken by John Vetcher, Julie's husband, and it has quite a lot of details in it, like some rocks and a pole, and that is very difficult to realize with pouring techniques. This is a little test piece that I did based on that photo, and I like it, but it does have quite a few mistakes in my eyes, so now let's see how I did for the real thing. But first, let me show you some of Julie's wonderful art. She is great at combining fluid techniques with other painting techniques, impasto paints, or like in these recent beautiful pieces, acrylic pen. If you haven't subscribed to her channel yet, please do so. It's linked in the description box. Now, this is John Vetcher's wonderful sunset shot taken in Bournemouth, England, that Julie and I both took as reference for our collaboration. Here you see my small test piece where I tested out colors that might work. I then compared this to John's photo and took some notes for myself that you see here. So these are the colors I'm going to be using. They're all custom mixed. On the left side, you kind of see the colors that I think I'm going to be using for the sky and the water. And on the right side for the land part. So I bring you in a little bit. That's my sun yellow. It contains some white house paint, some honey gold, it's a yellowish tone, satin enamel, some artist loft yellow, and I don't know what else. Orange and white house paint mix. Sort of a reddish coppery tone. I didn't have any copper, so I used the DecoArt Metallics in Grenade. The DecoArt Metallics in aged bronze, some Modern Masters brass, some orange house paint, some white house paint. I think that's about it. That's a pearl white-like tone. It contains Modern Masters pearl white and a house paint, leftover house paint that by the name of Cream in My Coffee. This is a metallic shade, mainly Modern Masters brass. And I think also some orange and some purple house paint to tone it a bit down because I don't want my painting too shiny and I also don't want too many cells to develop, so I don't want to use pure metallics. This is a light blue house paint mixed with a bit of white house paint. This is not black, it contains black house paint but also a purplish and a blue house paint, so it's like a very, very dark purplish blue or blue black. This is orange house paint mixed with a bit of the Modern Masters brass and a bit of yellow and a bit of white. to like a brownish orange shade. And these are just the gray drippings from my last painting project. I'm not sure if I'm going to be using them, but if I need a gray color, then I'm using this. All paints are mixed with just water and a little bit of GAC at 100 to a fairly thin consistency. You see, maybe you see it, I don't know, it's very thin, almost like milk. The canvas is level, now we can start with our pour. And I'm pouring the sky first, so just putting down puddles of colors. The pouring process you see here, actually most of the video is sped up times five. Original pouring and painting and filming time was more than 2 hours, so that would have bored you to death if I had left it at that original speed. I hope that this way it's not too fast that you still can follow what I'm doing, but also not too boring to watch. I chose to do a Dutch pour blowout with my hair dryer for the sky, which I will then tilt out to get a fairly smooth, not too dramatic or busy sky. And one thing that intrigued me about the reference photos, photo where these very light, fluffy, soft clouds thinly covering the sky and the sun, and I'm trying to capture that by using my pearl white mixture and swiping and smearing across the sky area. I'm now continuing by working on the water and horizon area, mainly using a smear swipe technique and some tilting, of course, to straighten it all out. And I looked again at the photo and noticed that there is actually quite a bit more gray in the sky, like very light, small gray clouds, and that's what I'm trying to add now with my palette knife and my muddy gray paint drippings and some pearl white. The process for this painting is actually quite different from what I usually do. Usually I start with a technique that I find interesting and want to try out, and then I see what that gives me and how it looks, and then I work from there inspired by the behavior of the paint. But this time I needed to find techniques that match the photo reference that I was meant to work with. That was a real challenge. I think I succeeded to some extent, but it was a real struggle, as you notice, and that's also why the painting took me very, very long. So here I'm blowing on the paint to give the clouds some shape. So now comes something interesting. Maybe you sometimes want to do a landscape with a sun in it, and this is my method of pouring a sun. I just pour puddles of yellow and white and whatever colors your sun has on top of each other, and then I blow on top. And in this case, I also lightly swiped across with pearl white because the sun in the reference photo is lightly covered by those fluffy white clouds. However, when you do this, probably some of your pains will be thinking, or they did in my case, and it's probably a common thing to happen, and that means that your son loses some of its shape, and it actually helps to repeat the adding color and blowing on top a few times during the pouring process until the paint is a little bit more set up and it doesn't change so much anymore. Now doing a similar thing for the places where the sun reflects in the water. I have waited about 45 minutes for the sky part to set up a little bit and not move so much anymore before I started to pour the land part, meaning the beach and that puddle of water with the sky reflecting in it. And for this I chose the method of adding three flip cups, because that way I could get the composition and direction of the paints the way I wanted it to be. As I needed to tilt these parts in a different direction to get that diagonal composition as in the reference photo, it was helpful that I had let the sky set up a little bit so that it didn't get completely distorted. However, as you can see, I still got a little bit of wriggliness around the horizon there, and I have to correct this now. I decided to add another flip cup for this water puddle because there were just slightly too many cells, and that way the water puddle looked just too shallow, not as full of water as it was in the reference photo. So with the second flip cup I try to match those colors a little better. And then I'm smearing some more blue on top to get the right color and the right shape. And now adding some shading with my palette knife and my muddy gray drippings, which were actually really helpful for this painting. You know, as you've heard in the beginning, I didn't even know if I'm gonna use them, and I actually used them quite a lot in the end. Now I had looked at the reference photo again and have seen that the light reflections and the water created slightly more vertical lines in that water puddle, and that's what I'm trying to create now with those paper towel swipes. Before doing this painting, I was contemplating very long time how I'm going to do those rocks and the pole, and was thinking of maybe just painting it all in, but then I decided to pour as much as I could, and so now here I'm trying to flip cup the shape of that rock. It's my dark blue purple black mix and my gray paint drippings in this flip cup. I'm starting to correct the shapes of those rocks with my palette knife and also adding some light reflections in some small water puddles that you see at the bottom of those rocks on the photo. And now I'm redoing the sun reflection in the water there because it got lost under my flip cup. Now I'm working on the sun reflection at the corner of that water puddle. Using spoon swipes to correct the shape and the color of those rocks a little bit. You will see me correcting this many more times, and I will probably not comment on all of those at times, but just let you watch the video and listen to the music. Now I added more of my copperish tone to the sky because I just felt that the sky needed to look a little bit warmer. However, this was difficult because already a lot of the color has set up and was beginning to get too dry to actually properly work with it. So for that reason, paint getting too dry, I just couldn't do much more fluid work on this, and I had to finish the details after drying. So here I'm using a sponge brush wrapped in plastic wrap and dipping in my fluid paints to correct some details. I have seen Priscilla Betzel of Expressionist Art Studio using that method recently in a beautiful landscape of a tree, and I thought I'd try it out. My horizon wasn't perfectly straight, so I used painter's tape and my palette knife dipped into fluid paints to correct this. And some more touch-ups here and there. The poor part is almost finished. But maybe this isn't a poor part anymore, maybe it's just painting, depends on the definition. I decided to lighten up those rocks a little bit at the top with my gray paint dripping mix in my palette knife to give it more rocky shapes and also to show some of the light that still makes it across those rocks and falls onto the rock, which you can actually see if you look more closely at the reference photo. It's not all black. So the shadow cast by the rock that was created with my flip cup was just too big. It just looked odd and out of place, so I corrected this a little bit too. Final touch-ups, but you see those landmark poles are still missing. What I'm going to do about that? Here I try to add a pole with a stick dipped into my fluid paints, which worked to some extent, but I also made a bit of a mess with the sky area where I still had some wet paint. And here I must admit I cheated a little bit, because after doing my pour I realized that By the position of those rocks and the sun, I just had a different angle or frame of that landscape than in John's photo, so I actually decided to crop his photo a little bit to match the composition of my painting and only paint in a small part there at the left side of that rail structure and not the complete one. I'm using an acrylic pen, Posca pen, and my stirring sticks as a ruler to complete this painting. And here it is, it's finished, sort of impressionistic looking. What do you think of it? Please leave a comment and maybe a thumbs up. Here's a comparison of my painting and a cropped version of John's photo. And some details of my painting that I like in particular. Please subscribe to my channel and head over to Julie's channel, of course, if you haven't seen her version of the scene yet. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate you.